was there when I first opened up my eyes, and who was there to heal the hurt when I first learned to ride, and who never missed a game, celebrate me what a loss. Yes, my father was. When adolescent years had come, who helped me understand? And when the winning point was scored, who in victory raised my hand? And when I hung my head in shame, was there to lift it up? Yes, my Father was. My Heavenly Father has always been there for my away, and who's on the other end when I lift my heart to pray, and who's always by my side to help me make it through.
Daniel in the lion's den, oh Daniel in the lion's den, Daniel in the lion's den, oh Daniel in the lion's den, oh Daniel in the lion's den, Daniel in the lion's den. Lord, have mercy on me.
Cause it's now is my need in time.
Now is my need in time.
So that God sent an angel down. God sent an angel down.
God sent an angel down.
And that angel locked the lion's jaw.
The angel locked that lion's jaw.
jaws, oh, the angel locked the lion's jaw. The angel locked that lion's jaw.
Yes, Father, yes. Thank you, Father, thank you.
Hallelujah.
Woo.
Amen.
Thank you, Master.
Thank you,
Father.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
First lady.
Tantum ergo sacramentum veneremo genui, et antiquum documentum nova cedat ritui, preste fides supplementum sensum defectui. Genitori, genitoque, placet jubilatio, salus ane, vertus quoque, sit et benedictio, procedenti, abutroque, capacit laudatio.
Today we celebrate Corpus Christi, celebrating the body and blood of Jesus. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us put ourselves before God's mercy. Lord Jesus, you come to give healing. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to give forgiveness to us. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to nourish us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wondrous sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant, we pray, that each of us may revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood and be strengthened by it through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In those days, after Abram's return, King Melchizedek of Salem brought out bread and wine. He was priest of God Most High. He blessed Abram and said, "Blessed be Abram by God Most High, maker of heaven and earth. And blessed be God Most High, who has delivered your enemies into your hand." And Abram gave him 1/10 of everything, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The Lord said to my Lord, "Sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstool." You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The scepter of your power the Lord will stretch forth from Zion, rule in the midst of your enemies. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. Yours is princely power in the day of your birth in holy splendor. Before the day star, like the dew, I have begotten you. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. The Lord has sworn, and he will not repent. You are a priest forever according to the order of Melchizedek. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Brothers and sisters, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus spoke to the crowds about the kingdom of God and healed those who were in need to be cured. The day was drawing to a close, and the 12 came to him and said, "Send the crowd away so that they can go and to the surrounding villages and countryside to lodge and get provisions, for we are here in a deserted place." But Jesus said, "Feed them yourselves." They said, "We have no more than 5 loaves and 2 fish, unless we are to go and buy food for all these people." For there were about 5,000 men. And Jesus said to his disciples, "Make the people sit down in groups of about 50. They did so and made them all sit down. And taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke them and gave it to them, to the disciples, to set before the crowd. And all ate and were filled. What was left over was gathered up into 12 baskets of broken pieces." My brothers and sisters, our salvation and the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, church, here we are on the Feast of Corpus Christi, Father's Day, and Juneteenth. Now, that's a lot to cover in one sitting. So I'll start off by wishing all the fathers happy Father's Day, asking the blessings of God, our Father, to strengthen you in that in which he has called you to by giving you a new name, Father, one likened to his own, Abba, Father. Juneteenth, we remember liberation and freedom. Simon Burke sings this song, and one of the lyrics is, "None of us are free. If one of us is chained, none of us are free." So the concept there on Juneteenth is that the last of the notification to the last of the slaves, which were still had not been set free in Texas. But as it says in the song, that none of us are free unless all of us are free. The scripture says, when one in the body rejoices, we all rejoice. And so how do we bring these three great feasts together? Father's Day, Juneteenth, and Corpus Christi. I think what we do is to realize that true freedom comes from God the Father. Amen? That true freedom is fought for every day in the fight for freedom and justice and righteousness for all people. And we must realize the strength to live out our lives comes to live out as our lives, our calling as fathers, comes from God the Father and comes from Christ, who sacrificed himself for each of us to be free from death, sin, and the grave. This is where we find ourselves, in the middle of a mystery. There is no doubt that Jesus is a mystery, that transubstantiation, that means the changing of bread and wine into the body of Christ, is a mystery, but moreover, a miracle. I remember when I was a young altar boy, and somehow at Mass we ran out of Eucharist. And Father turned back the last couple of people in line, indicating that we were out of the body of Christ. Then suddenly it dawned on me, wait a minute, I know where they keep Jesus. I don't know how Father don't know, we got boxes of Jesus in the altar boy sacristy. Brothers and sisters, at that time, Jesus was more of a mystery to me than he is now. But the fact is that even now as an adult, I don't always understand the mystery of Jesus and how he's present. He presents himself to us in so many ways. And even the mystery of the miracle, the bread and wine becoming the body of Christ. I'm often overwhelmed and sometimes under-attentive, have mercy, to that miracle that happens. And forget that the body of Christ that strengthens me, and to be reminded that what we do here is truly a miracle. The church points us to scriptures today to remind us, to strengthen us, to fortify us, to help us understand, to give us a glimpse into the mystery and allow us to embrace the miracle. What we do is truly a miracle. It doesn't change in its appearance or its taste or its texture, but that bread and that wine becomes the body of Christ. In order for us to live out the command that Jesus gives us in the scripture, Jesus says in John 6:53, amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat of the flesh of the Son of Man and drink of his blood, you shall not, somebody say shall not, have life within you. See, if Jesus makes a command, then he'll make a way. Amen? And what we do is not to purely reenact or remember, but to embrace, to involve, and to become the body of Christ. What we do is real. In John 6:55-57, hear these words. My flesh is real food. My blood, real drink, poured out for the world. And whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood dwells in me and I in him. We become one in Christ through the Eucharist. In verse 57, just as the living Father sent me, I have life because of the Father, and so whoever feeds upon me will have life because of me. The real presence of Christ. I know we've been going through a lot of stuff. The world is unpredictable. And that disease and despair is all around us. If you have been staying away from the Eucharist table because of disappointment or despair, because you think you're not worthy, remember, it is Christ who knew us and died for us. There is forgiveness promised to those who seek it. If you've been staying away because of the pandemic, find a small mass at a quiet place. There's somewhere you can obtain the Eucharist. Or call us. We will bring it to you. Aretha Franklin said, ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough that Jesus cannot come to you wherever you are. This is our strength. This is our call. This is our purpose. We gather in this place to be nourished by the body and blood of Christ. Real food. Real drink for the salvation of the world. And he took the bread and gave thanks and broke it And he gave it to them, saying, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, saying, "This is the cup, the new covenant in my blood, poured out for you. It is by the will of the Father, the power of the Holy Spirit, through the blood of Jesus, that bread and wine becomes the body and blood of Christ. And we receive it and are strengthened by it." Amen.
Let's pray together our belief. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, a life for the world to come. Amen. Let us present to the Lord our needs. On this Father's Day weekend, for all the fathers and grandfathers and godfathers and playfathers, that they will continue to be men of faith, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all those who are victims of gun violence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of Ukraine, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
I invite you to lift up your own needs and concerns. Lord God, we lift up to you these and all those needs that weigh in our hearts. We make them known in confidence through your Son, Jesus, who lives with and through us now and forever. Amen. As we prepare the altar, I want to thank you for your continued support. This is a unique week. We got mail 6 out of 6 days. Go figure. But, you know, thanks for all of you who continue to support us through PayPal and parish self-giving, especially during the summertime. The need often is greater, so your donations are a blessing to so many people who are struggling. Lord God, we ask that you bless this bread and this wine, fruit of the field and fruit of the vine, so it soon becomes the body and blood of Jesus. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours become acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we present here through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through your Son Jesus. For Jesus is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of everlasting sacrifice. He was the first to offer himself as a saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as a memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. As we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. We join all the angels as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts.
are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed, entered willing into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, said once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. And let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Give me thanks you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Wilton, our Bishop, and all of the women and men who lead and guide the church. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, Martin, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray for the fullness of God's kingdom as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
For those who are blessed to have others around, please share a sign of the Lord's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him, it takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We celebrate Corpus Christi, the body of Christ. I invite those who cannot be physically in a church to spiritually ask the risen Lord present in the Eucharist to give you that grace and strength to continue to be open to the grace and nourishment that comes from Jesus. This is the body of Christ.
Amen.
Of life, you come to me.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may delight for all eternity in that share of your divine life, which continues to strengthen us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to pray with me our family prayer for justice and human dignity, crafted by Cardinal Gregory and the bishops of our diocese. Loving and faithful God, we come to you, Father, to ask that through your Son Jesus and in communion with the Holy Spirit, you help us in the battle against America's original sin of racism that divides us from being the body of Christ that we are called to be as your children. We implore you to give us your wisdom so that we may build a community founded on the gospel message, the life and dignity of all people, from the womb to the tomb, and to live in communion like the divine communion of the Holy Trinity. Bless parents that they may form their children of faith to love one another regardless of skin color, ethnicity, and national origin, just as Jesus loves us. Bless and protect all of us as we live in our faith and be an instrument of your peace, as St. Francis said. Fill us with a thirst for justice and righteousness. Hear our prayer and give us the courage, compassion, and perseverance to root out any form of injustice within our communities and to bring the healing love of Christ to all in need. Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of our Church, hasten to help us and intercede on our behalf so that our archdiocese can continue to witness to the gospel message to the life and dignity of all people. Amen. Remind you that coming up next Tuesday is the D.C. primary, and so we encourage those who have not voted. I mean, I voted by mail 2 weeks ago. It was wonderful. They mailed the ballot to me. I checked it off and sent it back. It is... Deacon Bobby said, talking to some people recently, you might know Robert White is on the ballot, and I encourage you to vote for him, not because of politics, but because that's my son. That's my boy running for mayor. So that works for me. He's also a member of the church, who would guess? Anyway, as we celebrate Juneteenth, we'll have a special thing on Sunday for those who are physically in church as we celebrate that now federal holiday, which I think is awesome. And today we also celebrate Father's Day weekend. So all those who are fathers, grandfathers, godfathers, expected fathers, play fathers, we'll do a blessing for all of those folks. So if you're home with some of those men that are in that category or other men of faith in your household, I invite you to extend your hands over their head and I will pray. Let us pray. Lord God, we give you thanks and praise for all the men of faith that make up our community, those present and those scattered all over. We give you thanks and praise for the fathers and grandfathers and godfathers and playfathers and expectant fathers. Continue to give them a sense of awe in your presence, Lord, that you bless us in so many amazing ways, especially with our children and our grandchildren, for all those young people that you often put in our care for many, many years. Continue to give all of our fathers that protection, that wisdom, that strength, that openness to your word, Lord, and openness to your spirit, so they can continue to be signs to their families and to the communities and those people around them that you are truly alive and that you are with us. We ask always blessings to the power of your Son, Jesus, who lives with and through us now and forever. And let us say, amen. I think that's all I have. Oh, birthdays. I knew there was a birthday. Miss Gwen Barnes, who is 98 on Monday, I believe. Isn't it amazing? 98. She was here at church a few months ago. She came by for Easter time. 98 years old. Still wisecracking. She always has some kind of wisecrack for me, no matter every time I see her. It's wonderful. What a blessing. And Dominique's birthday is on Juneteenth, on Sunday, the 19th of June. I'm sure there's more birthdays I'll find out about soon. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord continue to bless us, that we will find ways to receive Jesus in Eucharist, so we can continue to be nourished by Jesus, so that we can be a sign of the body of Christ to others. Let the church say, Amen. Amen. May the Lord give blessing in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Come adore this wondrous presence, bow to Christ, the source of grace. Here is kept the ancient promise of God's earthly dwelling place. Sight is blind before God's glory, faith alone may see His face. Glory be to God the Father, praise to His co-equal Son. Adoration to the Spirit, bond of love in Godhead one. Blessed be God by all creation, joyous